presents America's finest sports spectacle, the Roller Derby. Official figures prove that Blatt's is the largest selling beer in Milwaukee and in all Wisconsin. So for quality, buy Blatt's, Milwaukee's finest beer.
Once again, it's the Roller Derby coming to you from the Philadelphia Arena in Philadelphia. We're about to go into the seventh period of tonight's skating with the score, New York 10, Philadelphia 8. And the score in games is Philadelphia 4, New York 2. Here's the team at the moment for Philadelphia, number 31, Irish Ashbacker, number 32, Betty Joe Harris, 34, Gloria McAuliffe, 35 is Captain Bobby Johnstone, 38 is Geraldine Borofsky. For New York, 22 is Captain Jerry Murray, 24, Gloria Brent, 26, Virginia Rushing, 29, Helen Gardner, 30, Lillian McConnell. But we have action on the track, and here's Ken.
All right, Geraldine Borofsky will begin for the Candy Stripe Jersey team, the Philly team. Coming up in there now, Borofsky holds the lead down, followed by Virginia Rushing of the New York team, number 26 in the black uniform with the white stripe just above the elbow. Here they come now, moving in. Borofsky moves in. The blocker back there is Gloria Brent, Brent of New York, number 24, blocking back Borofsky. Borofsky, number 38, trying to get in there, still trying to keep Rushing behind also. But Rushing is moving up in there, but Rushing has not scored. He has to pass a member of the opposition. Cannot pass another jam skater for a point, so Rushing has yet to score, and Borofsky has yet to score. Borofsky is knocked way back by number 24, Brent. Clock shows 45 seconds to go. Rushing moving in, coming in on the blocker, and it's number 34, McAuliffe. McAuliffe from Philadelphia blocking back on Rushing. Rushing trying to get in, almost losing her helmet. Look at her helmet bobbing and weaving and dances off her head. She's hit hard in there by nice blocking on the part of McAuliffe, who is having a tough job trying to keep her behind. She does. She fools Brent and pulls away. Beautiful blocking by McAuliffe from Philadelphia. Boy, McAuliffe going down now on Rushing. Rushing lost her helmet in that scuffle of hard blocks put out by number 34 of Philadelphia, Gloria McAuliffe. McAuliffe blocking back now. There's about 5 seconds to go. Here comes Rushing around the outside, trying to get in. Hit, slow down beautifully. 2 seconds to go. Can't get in there. Good defensive play on the part of McAuliffe of Philadelphia. No score. The score means 10-8. New York leads Philadelphia. Now, you friends in New Jersey, remember the opening of the Roller Derby in Newark, New Jersey at the Roseville Armory on Roseville Avenue, December 28th. Yes, a great Christmas present for the New Jersey fans as the New Jersey team comes home to go against Philadelphia starting December 28th in the Roseville Armory on Roseville Avenue in Newark. Now, tickets are on sale at Adler's Shoe Store, 835 Broad Street in Newark, and the phone number for reservations in Newark is Market 33334. Jot that down, Market 33334. That's Newark, New Jersey, the opening of the Roller Derby on December 28th in the Roseville Armory. Buzzer sounds, all set to go. Up in front now, Helen Gardner, number 29, ready to take out. Gardner moves in there. Borofsky out again, number 38. Geraldine Borofsky of Philadelphia on the move, followed by Helen Gardner. Helen Gardner, sister of Mary Gardner, number 29. Mary Gardner, star of the Washington team. Up in front now, moving in there. Borofsky, followed by number 27, Lillian McConnell, followed by number 31, and it is Irish Ashbacker. Direction is Jacqueline Harvey, number 27. Harvey, number 27 up there with Helen Gardner, Borofsky, and Irish Ashbacker for Philadelphia. Ashbacker takes over the lead, number 31, moves in there. 45 down, a minute and 15 to go. Four potential scorers moving in. Backer starts to cut loose. Ashbacker on the move now. Jacqueline Harvey trying to stay with her. The big gal, Ashbacker from Philly, is really moving. Now the two have dropped almost out of the play. Helen Gardner and Borofsky are dropping back. And now Harvey takes over the lead for New York. Jacqueline Harvey, number 27. With number 31, Irish Ashbacker right behind her. Back of the pack now, coming in
to lap the opposition. Pass one or two members of the other team, it's 1 point. Three or four, 2 points. We pass five, it's 5 points. Jamming period's 2 minutes. The skating period is 15 minutes. That two-minute period ends, or rather the jam ends when that two-minute time limit is over, or the 15-minute racing period is over, or if the leading jam skater falls or leaves the track with both skates. The jam also ends if the leading jam skater places his or her hands on hips or gets a penalty. And as you know, penalties are handed out for holding, illegal blocking. They're considered minor fouls. Then we have unnecessary roughness and so on. And if you happen to get up to 12 minutes of penalties, you're automatically out of the game. Of course, a severe penalty would result in your being thrown out right then and there. All right, action on the track here.
Number 23, Mary Lou Palermo, on a move on this one, and Murray blocks back four. Mary Lou pulling away, but here comes the big gal, Kay Verba, number 37 of the Philadelphia team, moving after. Murray and Johnstone also up in there, and Murray blocks Johnstone, and Palermo holds the lead down. Here comes Murray in the picture. Is working on Johnstone. Beautiful blocking by Corey Brent in front of that pack. Two against one. Bourbon in a tight spot now. Bourbon in the middle of these two New York players. Murray on the left. Claremore in the lead. There's Brent blocking on Ashbacker in the front of the pack. Johnstone, number 35, tries to come out. And Brent is after and blocks her up. Two against one on this jam. New York has the edge. Claremore, Murray, Kay Verba. In there, a foul is called. Betty Jo Harris, illegal use of her hands. Philadelphia player off the track, using her hands illegally. Down goes Verba, and the two New York players are out loose. Verba down, getting up. A minute down, and one to go on this jam now. The two top Philadelphia New York players move in. Murray the captain, and Murray's number one gal, Mary Lou Palermo. Here they come rolling in there. A good chance to score a lot of points here. It all depends on the defense of Philadelphia. The two big gals back here, good blockers. Kay Verba, number 37. The bronze bully from Philly, the captain, Bobby Johnstone, looking over his shoulder now. Johnstone and Verba on the defense. Here comes Palermo. Here comes Murray moving in there. Up goes 35 seconds to go. They're moving in. Verba blocks up one, blocks back the other. Verba's doing it all herself, doing a swell job. Verba chopping up both of them, but now Palermo scores over. Palermo passes one, Murray passes, they both score. And here comes Palermo moving in now, and Johnstone racks it down the goal with his scoop. 1 point by Murray, and the score moves on all the way to New York.
Multiply this crowd by thousands, and you gain some small idea of the enthusiastic demand for Blatt's, Milwaukee's finest beer.
Milwaukee, and I ought to know, it's the same old story wherever you go. This is the tune you will always hear. Blatt's is Milwaukee's finest beer.
Brian Donlevy says,
take it from me, Blatt's is Milwaukee's finest beer. I live there. I ought to know.
Time out has been taken by New York. They're talking things over. That scoreboard, I believe, is incorrect. The scoreboard showed New York 10 and Philadelphia 8, and it's going up now. Now it's been corrected. It's New York 12 and Philadelphia 8, and that's just been placed up on the scoreboard now. There it is, 12 to 8. Want to keep you well informed, want you to know everything that's going on right here at the Roller Derby. All right, time is in again. That whistle means get going, get in there. New York going back on track. They now have a four-point lead. They realize, of course, that Philadelphia is going to take the stoppers out here and go for that five-pointer just as they did before. Speck Saunders went for a five-pointer, picked up two, and put his team right back into the game. Had he passed one more skater, he would have had those 5 points, and they'll be looking for 5 points right now, which would put their team out in front by a single point. Of course, these games are always very closely, very tightly played. Any one of these coaches, any one of these captains will take a victory by a single point. Kent?
All right, number 25 moving out on this one. A nice break. Peggy Smalley followed by Irish Ashbacker. Bobby Johnstone trying to get loose, and Murray takes her high. New York has certainly been far from this half. Look at Johnstone, right Murray in the box, and Murray right back at her. Johnstone back at her. Up in there. minutes and 29 seconds to go in this game period. 45 down, a minute and 15 to go now. Hatchbacker on the inside, hits up on number 25, slows her down. Number 25 moving in. 5 minutes and 6 seconds to go in this skating period. Minute down and one to go in this jam. 31 has it now. Number 25, Peggy Smalley, hit and almost lost her helmet. Smalley and Ashbacker coming around. Defense is forming in the back end. Kay Verba, number 37, back at a block out now. Verba will try to stop up number 25, Peggy Smalley, moving in for the New York team. Smalley coming in there, right behind her. Ashbacker moves in on Mary Lou Palermo. Palermo back there in the blocking spot. Here comes the play. Peggy Smalley hitting in, and Verba blocks back. Here comes Ashbacker moving in on Mary Lou Palermo. Irish Ashbacker in on Palermo. Now Palermo back in the blocking spot for New York. 15 seconds to go. Palermo slows down on Ashbacker, and number 37, Kay Verba, slows down on Peggy Smalley of New York. They can't get in there. Good defensive play. There's about 5 seconds to go on this one now. Number 31 hits in on Palermo. Can't get by. And Kay Verba is falling. No score on that one. And the score means 12-8 New York leads Philadelphia. I want to repeat to your friends that just joined the ABC Network to be with us on the Blatz telecast at the Roller Derby. It's set to open December 28th for the 9th Regiment Armory in Lower Manhattan on 14th Street between 6th and 7th Avenue. Transportation from all parts of New York direct to the Armory. Tickets now on sale at Woodstock Hotel, 43rd Street off Broadway in New York. And remember, the teams opening that series is New York against Brooklyn. For information and for reservations, call right now. Judson 64646. Judson 64646 in New York.
Coming in for Philadelphia, number 37, Kay Verba. Number 33, Donna Jean Cox.
All right, the buzzer sounds. Mary Lou Palermo, number 23, up there. Palermo on the offensive now, moving in. 35, Johnstone up there, number 37, Kay Verba. Verba fouling in on Palermo. Mary Lou holding the lead down. Verba in second, Murray in third, Johnstone in fourth position, moving up. This Philadelphia team is taking a good whack out of New York here. And New York down a 4-1. And New York won last night's game. And they get the series set up for 4, losing 2. Out goes Murray. Out goes Palermo. Haver loose. Herman number 37 moving in there now. Herman coming in. On a double block by Murray and Palermo. The only one that can score. Herman knocked them both out of the play. Defensive part of the game. And that's the two New Yorkers, Palermo and Murray. Back to block out Kay Verba. Here comes seconds to go. 22, trying to get the field together. Might mention you fans up in Boston, don't forget the roller derby is now going on over at the Mechanics Building, and it ends Sunday afternoon, the big matinee on Sunday. You've got three games left up in Boston. There's Palermo wrapping it up. Murray, 6 seconds to go. They're up and Joe, and the time is running out.
Taste the jam when you choose Platts, Milwaukee's finest beer.
Behold, Mysterioso Platts, outstanding man of mystery. With nothing up his sleeves, you see, and now he has some bottle caps. He throws them up and thrice he claps. Down they come and spell out Blatz, a wondrous thing to see. And here he has upon the table a case of beer with a famous label. And now we'll see if he is able to make these bottles rise. The greatest feat of his career. He brings out not just any beer, but Blatz. This magic man is wise. Now we hear musicians tune and voices hum, and pretty soon there bursts upon us loud and clear that famous song of friendly cheer.
Oh, I'm from Milwaukee and I ought to know, it's the same old story wherever you go. This is the tune you will always hear. Blatz is Milwaukee's finest beer.
The men are out there skating now. Action on the pack. Here's Ken.
All right, Hank Goldberg out in front now, moving out with number 31, George Fulton, a very rough jam. There they are, going round and round. Oh, look at that little one. Goldberg, throw one on Big Georgie. He took it. George Fulton, Philadelphia, in the candy stripe jersey, number 31 with number 30 in the New York uniform. Hank Goldberg. Remember, each team on the jam. Got to circle that big oval, come all the way around that track, and pass, remember, the opposition within 2 minutes' time. Because of the 2 minute time limit at all jams. Incidentally, sport fans, we appreciate the wonderful letters you're sending in telling us about the roller derby and how you enjoy it on television and how when you attend the roller derby, it's so much better when you see it in person. And that's certainly true because as great as it is on TV, you've got to admit, you've got to be there. You're right in the scene of the action. Number 30 up in there now. Over, moving in. Number 31 with him, George Bolt.
That's right, Boat is shaken up there, kind of on the right side, almost too small in the back. And Georgie has really got himself an injury there. He's trying to skate it off. And Philadelphia takes timeout. Skating for New York, number 24, Ray Kresge, number 26 is Sam Marquise, 28 is Doug Motti, 29 is Joe Cosmore, and 30 is Hank Goldberg. Skating for Philadelphia is number 31, George Vogt, 32 is Captain Silverich, 37 is Phil Rip, 39 is Coach Elmer Anderson, and 40 is Charlie Saunders. Now, Silverich is serving the unexpired penalty of Captain Bobby Johnstone, who incidentally got 11 minutes so far in penalties. If she gets one more, she's automatically out of the game. Of course, she won't come back into this game unless it goes into sudden death overtime.
Why not pause just for a minute to the left?
Ah, there it is. Blatz spear. Timeout for Blatz. You see what's going on now is that the Philadelphia team, that's what you're looking at right now, is trying to set up an offensive pattern again. They've got their full strength in there, and they're going for the works to pull this game out, because if they win tonight, it is impossible for the world champion New York team to take this series from Philadelphia. On the other hand, New York, which is leading by 2 points, wants to talk it over so they maintain that advantage. Captain Silverich is back on the track so that each team is now at full strength. 12 minutes left in the game. 12 minutes.
All right, Big Doug Monty moves out. Number 37, Phil Rupp on the Philadelphia team comes out. Number 29, Joe Cosmo of New York hits up on Big Dave Leisman, and he comes out, and Leisman tails him. Silverich moving back in the game, finishing out the penalty time now. Both teams at full strength. There's two more games to go here at the Philadelphia Arena between out of it. And now it's Jojo Pospo on the loose for New York with Big Duck Marty. And there they are. Pospo without the headgear on. Number 29 holding the lead down. New York on the move. Down that back far side. Up that high turn. Down this side right at you. Here they come. Hell is the two boys that can do the damage. Philadelphia man loose. Beck Tonner's trying to get loose now. Tonner's trying to come out on this one. Anderson got a penalty for holding. There he is, getting off the track. Coach Anderson, Philadelphia, got a penalty for holding. Here comes the play, number 29 and number 28 move in a double block. Rich over Rich, number 32 and number 37. Still rough in a double block. Back in a block out, slow down on these two. And Beck Tonner's is coming all the way around now. If Tonner's can get in there and cut this jam off, he will certainly help his team because this is dynamite. Watch Beck come around in this picture now.
Perspiration from his eyes. A very modest, fine athlete. The grace, the agility, the speed with which he moves is absolutely tremendous. Little work going on. They're going to work on Doug Monty over there. They knocked Monty down. He had tried to block Silver Rich and gave Silver the works. Perfectly legal. But then Big Bill Rupp decided he better do something about it because he's near a Monty size, and he did do something about it. Philadelphia is trailing only by 1 point. The score now is New York 12, Philadelphia 11. 9 minutes and 20 seconds to go in this skating period.
All right, the buzzer sounds. Moving up in there. Coming hard now. And it's Joe Cosmo, number 29. Number 32, Silver Rich up in there. And number 24. And it's Ray Kresge to score 12 to 10. As they move in. Rich out number 2-1 now, moving around. 7 seconds to go in the game. And number 32 on the inside. Rich stops the jam off. The leading jam skater stopping it up. And now Joe Hassel.
All right. 8 minutes and 30 seconds left to go in this game. New York maintaining that lead. Coach Elmer Anderson has come back into the game. So that each team is now again at full strength. Here we go, Ken.
All right, coming out there. Silver Rich moves in on this one now. Rich out there with Coach Elbows Anderson out of the penalty box and out of the dam. Number 24, Ray Kresge moving out for the New York team, followed by Coach Joe Cosmo. Number 29, so we have two members of each team on the dam in a very heated game and a great series between these two great teams. Coming on very sly now. He may get called for a double block on these two leading Philadelphia players, and Anderson is watching for it. Stops up on knock, come down. Look at that nice block by Anderson. Knocking out number 24, Kresge. Hits up and nine. Cosmo! Cosmo down. Beautiful block by Anderson. And it's going
Tasting this makes me thirsty for a tall, cool glass of Blatz, Milwaukee's finest beer.
I'm from Milwaukee and I ought to know. It's the same old story wherever you go. This is the tune you will always hear. Blatz is Milwaukee's finest beer.
Try Milwaukee's finest and largest selling beer today.
All right, waiting for this jamming period to get underway. There's the score. New York 12, Philadelphia 11. And again, was that brilliant skating by Silver Rich. The very tricky skating that time is Saunders, number 40. Managed to pull the defenders up to the top part of the track. And then Silver went down, came through on the inside. So very exciting that, as a matter of fact, the six other skaters, the pack, which was about a half a lap away from them, just seemed to coast along and take a look to watch the maneuvers to see whether or not these two skaters would set up an offensive pattern to break down the defensive setup of Cosmo and Monty, and they did. All right, 6 minutes left to go in the game. Anything can happen in 6 minutes. That's a lot of time in the roller derby.
All right, the buzzer sounds. Out comes Doug Monty. Monty moving out there now with Spec Connors, number 40. Monty and Spec, number 22, Bogash, number 23, Russ Bastro, moving in there. Bogash on the inside, driving hard. Billy Bogash on the road, followed by Russ Bastro, his captain. Bogash over to Bastro. Bastro loose. All to 11 and score. Only 1 point difference now. New York holding it. Seats are available. The box office open all day. And for reservations for tomorrow night, Friday, or the final game of this series in Philadelphia Saturday night, call Evergreen 61500. Evergreen 61500. There's Silver Rich talking to number 40. And the score, Joe, stays the same, 12 to 11.
That's right, Ken. We've got time here for one all-out jam. Both teams at absolute full strength. All of their stars are in there now. Philadelphia needs 1 point to tie it up and send it into overtime. They'll settle for that right now. New York, however, will do everything it possibly can to check them. 2 minutes and 48 seconds left in the game. New York 12, Philadelphia 11. Here they go.
All right. line. Number 29 picks up. Monty moves out. Followed by number 37. Moving in there with him. And it's still Rupp. Rupp and Monty moving in. Followed by Buddy Agassi, number 35. Number 22. And it's Billy Bogash. Two members of each team moving in. Time is running short. 2 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the game. The score 12-11. New York leads Philadelphia. They're panning it out now. New York's trying to get back in the series. There's Rich roughed up in there with beautiful pocket by Mastro, number 23. Bill Rupp on the move. Big Doug trying to chase him up there. There's Silver Rich now controlling the front of the pack because he's got two men out there along with two of the New York players. And it's even Steven on this one. Two potential scores for each team. A nice block by Big Doug Bonney. Bogash is up in there now. Buddy Atkinson up in there. 2 minutes to go in the game. 2 minutes to go. They're roughing in that pack now. Bogash trying to knock Buddy Atkinson out of the play. Big Doug Bonney takes down Rupp. He goes down. Bogash almost falls. Buddy Atkinson after him. And Buddy falls. Tough break. Oh, what a tough break that was. He missed the block on Bogash. Johnny went, and now Bogash is out there alone. Billy Bogash moving in for the New York team. Coming in the back of the pack on Phil Rupp. Rupp is back at a block out. A minute down and one to go and a minute and 34 seconds to go in the game. Here comes Bogash moving in and Buddy Agassi. Buddy Agassi back at a block out. Bogash moving in. Here's the play now. Agassi trying to keep Bogash out of there. Billy Bogash trying to move in. Tries on the inside. Can't do it. It's Buddy Agassi blocking back beautifully as Bogash, number 22, tries to get in there. Big Joe Cosmo, number 29, throws a block. 1 point for Bogash and a nice key block by Cosmo. Cosmo up on Rich. Pass two. Bogash pass two. Bogash pass two coming up now, and he passed three. Bob Fentner. He's gained 2 points already. Rich is after him now to try to stop him from gaining five. A minute and 59 seconds to go. That's all that's left in the game. Bogash has passed three now. He's trying 4-5. Phil Rupp being worked on by Cabral. But Bogash is having trouble getting by Rich. Rich is the guy that's instrumental in stopping him up from a possible five-pointer with 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second. And the jam is over. 2 points gained by Billy Bogash on a beautiful play. And the New York team leads with 34 seconds to go in this game. In fact, the score now is 14-11, New York leading Philadelphia. We want to mention to you friends along the Blatz Network tonight that the nickname contest is on. All you have to do is nickname your favorite team. Send your letter with your return address to your coach in care of Roller Derby office, Madison Square Garden. You might win some official Roller Derby skates, the kind the champions use. Nickname your team. Send it to Madison Square Garden in care of your coach. 6 seconds to go. 14-11 the score. 3 seconds. The gun is in the air. 2-1. And the crack of the gun. Final score, 14-11. And now, with only two games to go in this series in Philadelphia, we give you Joe Hassel.
Thank you very much, Ken. Well, this New York team maintained their advantage, racked up 2 points on the final jam to win this seventh game of a nine-game series. The final score here, New York 14, Philadelphia 11. The score now in games of Philadelphia 4 and New York 3. But another very exciting roller derby game. They're always very exciting. And of course, the star tonight, Billy Bogash, the great of this New York team, which is the world's champs. And speaking of stars, I know that Pat O'Brien, motion picture star, says that Flats is Milwaukee's finest beer. Well, Pat's from Milwaukee. He ought to know.
The Roller, America's finest sports spectacle, has been brought to you by Blatz, Milwaukee's finest beer. Yes, where America's finest beer is brewed, Blatz is the leading beer. As folks from Milwaukee will tell you, I'm from Milwaukee. I ought to know. Blatz is Milwaukee's finest beer.
This is ABC, American Broadcasting Company.